So I have trouble throwing things away, and you might even call me a hoarder. Case in point, this week I spent a good part of Christmas break fixing our 23-year-old washing machine. It stopped working on Tuesday, and I spent about 3 or 4 hours troubleshooting it and trying to diagnose what was wrong. After a bunch of disassembly and troubleshooting, I then spent nearly the cost of a new washer, over $500 in parts, and then another 3 hours after that studying the service manual and YouTube disassembly videos, and then on Christmas Eve, 3 hours from start to finish on repairs when the parts arrived. And now we have a working washing machine again, albeit still 23 years old and everything else is still just as old. You know, it probably made more sense just to go buy a new washer, but truthfully, this is not even the first time I did something illogical like this. Take the cars, for example. I have 3 perfectly working cars, 2 of which don't even get driven ever. And on top of that, if I ever needed to really get anywhere, I still have my dad's Accord and Joanne's Civic also, which I should add are all low mileage, super reliable, and super comfortable to drive. But instead, I voluntarily choose as tribute my 97 Honda Civic that's left me stranded 4 times so far. And it has over 278,000 miles on it right now, but in the same way, I just can't let it go. Even despite the fact that it leaks like a sieve, and whenever it rains, the trunk floods with water, so much so that I had to drill a hole in the trunk so the water could get out. But even despite all this, that didn't stop me from spending over 3 or even 4 times the cost of the car doing a whole bunch of costly repairs, including fixing a broken head gasket, which, you know, a lot of people would have just thrown the car in the trash at that point because it's just not worth the effort, time, and the money it takes to fix something like that. But no, not me. So after hours of work and research, hundreds of dollars in parts and tools, I still have this clapped out jalopy that just keeps me guessing all the time as to whether or not something else is gonna break. And you know, thinking about it more now, I think I've always had issues throwing things away and just saving a whole bunch of stuff just in case, or sometimes even just for the sentimental value. But all that's been changing ever since Joanna and I got married. And to be honest, sometimes it really feels like pulling teeth and I really hate it. The transition has been a lot harder on her than it has been on me. Because mom got sick, we weren't able to move out, and so she had to pack up her stuff and move in with my family. And because of that, there was a lot of need to clean out the old to make room for the new, since she was moving in and this was going to be her home as well. But when we first started, the process was brutal and it was so hard every step of the way. There were just so many things that I kept just in case. And also so many other things that I realized I was just keeping for sentimental value. Things like grade reports, homework, class schedules, textbooks. What if I needed to go back to school? And not just any school, but what if a wormhole opened and I went back in time and I had to go back to my high school? How would I know what class to go to and what the schedule was? How would I be able to study and get A's and earn my parents' love without the boxes of textbooks? And how would I be able to do math and use my calculator without my trusty TI-83 manual? It seems so silly to think about and talk about it now, but there were so many boxes of things that we had to go through and throw out just like this. We even had to throw out so many college acceptance packages. What if I went back and decided to go to those colleges now? There are even so many old games that we had to sift through and toss. Bless her heart, she let me keep some of them. But a lot of these games you can't even play anymore because their computers don't even have CD-ROM drives anymore. But what if one day I wanted to go revisit my childhood? And those are the things that were the hardest to throw away, the things that had sentimental value attached to them. And that seemed like, for me, it was everything. Like my Viper and Countach posters. You can't throw those away. I got those at the Scholastic Book Fair in 3rd grade. Or my favorite Hot Wheels diecast race car. Surely you couldn't expect me to let that go. And like our favorite Jenga set. There were so many times where we gathered around as a family to play that and now had fun knocking the towers over and rebuilding the blocks back up to go again. There's no way you can tell me to let that go. Or my Super Soaker XP150. I remember when mom and dad took us to the store to go buy that. It was at Toys R Us. And I convinced John to get the XP125 where I got the XP150. You can't expect me to let this go. I mean, there's so many memories tied to this thing. And plus, you realize that Toys R Us doesn't even exist anymore? This thing is practically a collectible. And don't even get me started on the Lego Metroliner box set 4558 that my dad got me as a surprise. That box is pristine. You already made me throw away the box that the shipping box came in. And granted, that one did have a few holes in it, but you can't make me throw away the original packaging for the set itself. I mean, you couldn't even find one of these even if you wanted to. I mean, I dare you to go on eBay to try.
I mean, this thing is definitely a collectible.
And it's probably even worth good money. Not that I'm ever going to sell it, because it's not like we need the money or anything. And please, please not the sash that I wore when I won Homecoming Prince as a sophomore in high school.
This sash is a one of one. I mean, this was the highlight of my high school career.
The absolute height, the apex of my popularity. How could you tell me to throw this thing away? I mean, think about all the hard work that went into this.
And all these old assignments. Look at all these reports. Look at all these A's on these perfect scores. Do you know how much work went into every single one of these? How could you expect me to let all this hard work just go? What if I needed to reference these reports sometime in the future?
But fine, as a concession, I promise I'll throw away the high school physics project that's been sitting on top of the bookcase for 18 years now. The one that Mark Sisip and I stayed up for 25 hours to try and finish, when we stayed up all night the night before finals to get done, causing us to fall asleep during Spanish final.
And again, it sounds so silly, but these are the types of conversations that we kept having to have every time we had to throw something away or clear something out, but we eventually did manage to get there.
But what else is funny is that a lot of the things that I showed previously were a lot of the things that, bless her heart, she ended up letting me keep.
And so this week, it just kind of got me reflecting. Why is it that I have such a hard time letting things go, and why do I form such attachments to such certain objects?
And really, for me, it's the memories that are attached to those items, the experiences and the stage of life that I was going through at the time, or the people that I was with in that period of time. Like the Civic, for example. I can remember my parents getting that car to replace the Prelude that I crashed and driving that car all throughout college. And I just used it for so much. Like, I remember when I took Minnie to the vet on her last day, how she was just in that car with me and she was just being so behaved. It's just experiences like that that make it hard to separate the memory from the object itself.
And so, you know, try as I might, you know, curse this good memory, we had to come to an agreement at some point about what could be kept, and most things had to be let go.
But it definitely took a lot of work, and truth be told, we're still in the process of clearing out a bunch of things, even though we're coming up on half a year since she had moved in. These days, as Joanne and I continue to build our lives together, and as we continue to take care of Mom as she declines in her dementia, I'm really finding it difficult on the prospect on what to do with a lot of things once Mom is no longer with us.
Thinking about what to do with things like her clothes, whether we're going to throw them away or donate them, and her other belongings, I already know it's just going to be so hard when the time comes.
It's just so hard to grasp how so many of these inanimate objects can have so much meaning. How to one person it could be meaningless, but to somebody else it could mean everything to them.
And especially certain objects that I know meant a lot to her. Like her piano, which she can't play anymore, that her dad gave to her as a gift. Thinking about what to do with that, you know, it's just so hard.
But I think if there's one thing that I've taken away from reflecting and preparing myself for all of this during this period, I'm trying to continually remind myself that it's not the objects themselves that have meaning, but it's the memories that continue on in us, the memories that we hold.
And on top of that, letting go of things is a necessary part in moving on to new stages of life.
And what's especially true and becoming particularly clear to me now is that being too anchored in the past can prevent growth and hold back the development of new things ahead.
I mean, I can't say enough about how patient Joanne has been with me in this whole process, but I can definitely see how much it wears on our new relationship,
especially when I'm reluctant and want to hold on to everything.
But sacrifices have to be made. Old things must pass for new things to grow. And in this case, the cleaning out of the old object is so much more, as it really mirrors the beginning of a new life for us and our new family.
So that's just what I wanted to leave with you guys, especially as we move into a new year. That more than just physical objects, I mean, obviously if you have to clean your room, then go ahead and do so. But more than just physical objects, that letting go of certain past attitudes, past prejudices, resentments, and even hurts, to do so, because that can really help free us and move us forward to the beautiful things that are ahead in our future.